bird on a tree. I'm just sitting here, I got time, it's clear to see. From up here, the world seems small. We can sit together.
Hi guys.
Hola.
So this morning I was showing you guys, everybody sitting around the fire. They were talking about safety and a whole bunch of stuff. And they do that every morning. Scott and I had some plans to go up and clean up an area. But they were talking about how strong the winds were today, which they are very strong, and the dust was flying everywhere. And, you know, you got to be careful out here in the desert with the, there's a...
Desert fever?
Something like that. Yeah. And I already have really bad allergies out here for this time of year, which every state kind of gets me. And somebody thought maybe I had asthma, but it's not. I have really bad sinuses. So, anyways, my point was, we left that area. We came down to do some laundry, get gas.
Get some water.
And if we haven't said this already on camera, which I don't know if we have about the dump here. Have we mentioned this?
So we are in the Ehrenberg Laundromat. And they have a RV dump. And I have heard rumors, and I believed them all, and until I just talked to the owner. So the rumor was that somebody sabotaged it. And I believed it. I was like, okay, well, that doesn't make any sense. Well, actually, the system is old, and it's failed. So it wasn't sabotage on it any part. They are not planning to fix it immediately, but they're going to have somebody look at it, and they figure they have to pump it out. And what they have to go to do from there is completely up to what the inspector says. So it's not sabotage like I thought, because that's what I thought it was.
Somebody said they put
concrete down in the hole. And I was like, well, that would do it.
Of course, then we were part of that rumor because we told somebody else that.
I did.
Right. But the main reason why I brought that up is that some people follow us to find out where to dump, where to get water. And we just want you guys to know you cannot do that here. But on the other side of the border in California, over in Blythe, they do have public works, right?
Water management or something like that. Yeah.
I believe it's $7 to dump there, but we talked to some friends of ours that just went over there, and it's a very nice establishment, and it's clean, and you can get your stuff all dumped out there. I don't know if they have fresh water.
They do not have water. Okay. They do not have potable water.
Okay.
There.
So you can still, here at the laundromat, you can still get potable water.
Yep.
And you can also go right down the road here. If you're in the parking lot and you're looking up at the highway to the left, if you take a left out of here, the parking lot, there is a kiosk down there that you can get drinking water as well, but that you will have to pay for.
Right. I believe it's $1 for 5 gallons or 25 cents a gallon. I haven't looked at it. I don't think it's changed in the last year, but
yeah,
salt-free water down there.
If you do come here to get water, I would just like to ask that you go in, and I don't even care if you buy a little 10-cent piece of candy. The gentleman who owns this place has always been a super nice guy, has always treated all of us nomads or us travelers with lots of kindness, and you can get your mailbox here, all kinds of stuff. But he runs a place for all of us to be able to do laundry,
water,
showers, if you need to have showers, water, and now his dump is out, and if you could just go in there and spend a little bit of money, it doesn't have to be much, just enough to, you know.
And he told me they're open every day from 7 in the morning till 6 at night.
Yeah.
Every day, even in the winter, in the summertime here, I said, so when it's 130, you're still here? And he's like, we're still open.
So, anyways, okay, we just wanted to clear up the rumor, if you've heard it, or if we had, I don't think we may have mentioned it on one of the videos, I don't know. And then just, if you come here and you get free water, you know, maybe go in and just, you know, buy something small or
super nice,
even something
here.
Large, you know, it doesn't matter. Okay, our second reason for talking to you guys is, we were in the laundromat doing our laundry, and we decided that we are going to get on the road. We're going to leave everybody behind. That's always love so them. Hard for us. Because we love traveling with everyone. They are going to stay up here at the cleanup. And we are going to go into Parker. We've got to go pick up some stuff at Walmart. I need to get some hooks and some junk. So we're going to go to Walmart. And we're probably going to stay at the casino for the holiday, I'm thinking is what we might do. We might find somewhere else to go. We're not really sure. We might even get a room. I don't know. I said something to Scotty.
Get a room?
We might get a room.
I was told... When I was 18, they told me that.
We might get a room.
Get a room.
Well, you know, here's the funny thing is, you live this lifestyle, and it's like a permanent vacation, but it's always kind of fun to go and, you know, stay in a hotel, and I know we did this last year, and I swore I was never going to stay in a hotel again after.
But that
we,
was not by choice.
Yeah, after we were in the hotel for a month, but it would be fun to just be in a room and, I don't know, spend
a bathtub?
Yeah, maybe. We have our shower, but it would be kind of nice to take a tub bath.
A 10-minute shower? Yeah. Without having to pay. Yeah,
okay, awesome. So anyways, that's kind of our temporary plan. We're not sure if that's going to happen, but we're going to take you guys with us. We are actually also going up to La Paz, and we're going to use the dump there. And
visit a friend real quick.
Visit a friend, and then we'll be on our way to Parker. So we'll take you guys with us.
And we have friends in Havasu that we are hoping to meet up with the holidays. So
we're not going to Havasu.
No, but they can come meet us.
Oh, maybe we're going to Havasu.
No, we're not going to Havasu. They can come and visit us. Later, guys. Pulled into the wrong La Paz.
So we're trying to find La Paz, La Paz South.
Yeah.
And I think we took the wrong one because the Scotty slows down a little bit here. I can show you guys that this is like, what does it say? Welcome to, I can't see, downtown North La Paz. Look at, they've got a shuffleboard or what, I don't know what they've got, but they've got all kinds of stuff set up here. So this must be where karaoke is right here, I'm thinking, because somebody said karaoke is over here. So Donnie, Pat, Marshall, yep, they set it all up. Maybe let's see, keep going, honey, and I'll let's see.
Oh, 9 to 5 p.m.
Oh yeah,
New Year's Eve.
They've got a whole look at their yard.
Oh yeah.
All right, so definitely in the wrong spot. Those people are all set up too. Goodness sakes. We are trying to get to South, and
we hit the one too soon.
Yeah, so we're going over. We're gonna get us some water and dump, because we do have a pass, so we can do that. Few people had made comments on other channels that was kind of a free-for-all over here. It is not. You will get a $180 ticket if you do not have a pass on your vehicle. So don't even try it. It's not worth it. That's a costly poo-poo dump.
especially when you could have just spent $180 and had 7 months worth of ability to use it. So I guess that's why it is.
Okay.
What it is.
So yeah, this is not where we need to be. We gotta go out. We gotta go to South. I'll tell you what, North looks pretty nice. I don't know why everybody goes to South.
Because I don't think they have water here.
Okay, but you could just drive out and go get water. You have to go get water anyways.
I think that's right? Why a lot of those guys have the utility vehicles we see with the big things
guys.
On them.
It's really bumpy.
So I think that's why they do that. You can stay out here and then go get your water at the other places.
We are going to stop and say hello to Carolyn. Carolyn's RV No, not Carolyn's RV life. I have heard that so much this week. We're gonna go say hi to Cece. The buffet. It's a Sunday brunch, and we're gonna go have some mimosas. Is that what they are? With Jimmy, Wandering Jimmy, Sal and Sharon from SNS and the RV Cats, and
RV Rebel Girl.
RV Rebel Girl. We just went over and asked Carolyn if she wanted to go with us. I'm not sure if she will or not, and a few other people. So anyways, that's what we're doing today on Sunday, and then Scotty's going to go watch the Seahawks.
Yeah.
And that's about it, guys. We just wanted to wish you guys a happy Sunday. Hope you guys all enjoy your day.
Say ya!
Well, good evening, everybody. So we did a video this morning just to say good morning to you guys, but we were rushing to get down to the buffet with the rest of the group, and Scotty was watching Seahawks, and now we just got back up here. Dana and the kids and Steve are here from Full Tiny House, and Dave from Dave's RV Life is here, and I think that's all that has shown up since we were gone. And Scotty's a happy boy. It's dark. You want to turn the light on?
Woo. No, the Hawks did well.
Yep, they did.
They always make a close game. That's what kills me.
Scotty's got only one light on. We didn't get a whole lot of sun here today. So, anyways, we're going to go ahead and call it a night. Not a big video, but just wanted to say good morning and good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Later, brother.